It's time for another Genealogy Showdown, and today we're pitting MyHeritage against Ancestry with their match filters and search functions. Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, where we help you understand your DNA, climb your family tree, and write your ancestor story along the way. Today we have another contest against two of the giants in genealogy, Ancestry and MyHeritage. To start with, we're going to look at the tree searching function. How are you able to search your DNA matches in relation to trees? Now on Ancestry, they have an option where you can go through and see whether people have private trees, public linked trees, or unlinked trees. Additionally, there is the option to look for common ancestors. All of these are related to the trees that people build on Ancestry. On MyHeritage, when we look at the all trees detail, there's actually five different ways that we can look. First, we can look for those that have a theory of family relativity. This has some automated features of actually connecting you through trees and records on MyHeritage. Next, we can look through whether they have smart matches. This is like if the information in the tree is similar enough that it's going to call it a smart match. We can look for shared surnames, we can look for shared places, and we can look for people that have a family tree. So there's several different options, including some more specific ones. So I'm going to give the win to MyHeritage in this category. Congratulations, MyHeritage. You have now 1 point to Ancestry, 0 points. Let's go on to our next category. And our next category is going to be relationship and shared CM. Now, both of these companies give you thousands of matches because their databases are large enough that they have that many, because we all share a lot of DNA. So can we filter down some of these matches into groups that we're more interested in? Over on Ancestry, there are three ways that you can filter by the relationship. So first, you can do the close relationship to fourth cousin. Now this would be people who share about 50 centimorgans or so, and it tells you how many people there are in that group. So how many matches you're gonna be looking at. You can also filter it down to the distant cousins, those that share even less DNA with you. And finally, this is a really great feature. They allow you to put in the amount of centimorgans that you want to look at. So for instance, if you want to sort by people who share between 90 and 400 centimorgans, this is where you're going to do it. Over on MyHeritage, they have the ability to look at close family members, they have the ability to look at extended family members, and they have the ability to look at distant relatives. Now, Ancestry combines the close family members and the extended family members into one group, whereas MyHeritage actually breaks it out into separate groups. Unfortunately, what MyHeritage doesn't have is they don't have the ability to search by a range of centimorgans. They also don't tell you how many matches are in each group, so you don't know how big of a list you're going to be seeing until you actually click on it. So I'm going to give Ancestry the win in this category. That means our contest is now tied up 1-1, but we're not done yet. Our next category is the location. And by location, I mean, where do your matches live? Now, this may be important, particularly for people who have immigrant ancestors that might have had their other relatives move to other parts of the world. Ancestry, at the top, you can list your relatives with a list, or you can go over to the map function. And the map is great because what it does is it shows you where your matches currently live. So you can see here that there's a couple of matches over in England and a couple down there in Australia. Well, those were probably going to be relatives from the immigrants from England that this person had. Now on MyHeritage, they don't have a map except on the individual people and then on a separate function. However, what they do have is they have the ability to look at your matches by country. So you can actually go through and select individual countries to look at those matches. Not only that, because this filter is integrated in with the other filters, you can look on something else, like let's say Smart Matches, and you could look for close family members, and then you could choose a country. Maybe you want to look for the ones in Australia or Canada as opposed to all of the others. And so this integrated part of the feature makes this really powerful. So I'm going to give the win to MyHeritage here for their location search ability. We've got a pretty good game going here. It is 2-1 in favor of MyHeritage. So next up, we have what kind of sort options. Since they both give you thousands of matches, can we sort these in different ways? Over on Ancestry, there is a sort button, and they have two ways that you can sort. Now, naturally, it is sorted by relationship, and the other way is you can sort it by date. In other words, which matches are the newest. This is really helpful if you've gone through a lot of your matches and then you go away for a time, come back, log on to the site, and you want to see who has joined the site since the last time I was on here. So they have a good function for that. Over on MyHeritage, they have four different ways that you can actually sort your matches. There is the shared segments. This is the number of shared segments. There is the largest segment. This is the one that probably most people think of. This would be from your closest relatives going back down. There is the full name if you wanted to actually sort people by their name. And then there is the most recent. This is similar to what Ancestry has. So there are actually some more options to sort in MyHeritage than in Ancestry, which means MyHeritage is going to win this round. That means that we now have MyHeritage at 3 and Ancestry at 1. MyHeritage is beginning to pull away, but will they be able to clinch the victory? Well, we'll see on this last category. And this is what I want to call extra filters. What can you filter with on each platform? And how might that help you? So let's start with Ancestry. Ancestry has some great extra filters. First off, you can filter by people you've messaged. You can filter based on notes that you've taken. So if you've taken notes on a group, you can also filter on the groups that you've put together. This is the color coding that is on the end there. So if you color code your matches, you can filter it where you're just looking at particular colors. All these things are different ways of looking at your matches to help you know what information you've already put into the system and maybe what information you need to put into the system. Now, over on MyHeritage, one of the great things that they have is that you can actually sort by ethnicity. If you want to use your ethnicity results, let's say, for instance, that you're adopted and you have an ethnicity results that is sub-Saharan Africa. Well, you're interested in your relatives who might also be with that same ethnicity. So you could sort on that ethnicity. The other thing that you're allowed to do is you're allowed to export this match list to a spreadsheet. You can export all this data, which is wonderful if you're like me and you're crazy and you like spreadsheets and you have different ways that you've thought of sorting things that MyHeritage hasn't thought of. So I like to do this a lot. I do it all the time. Now this was hard because both of them actually had some really good ways of sorting, and so I made this a tie. I'm gonna give a point to each company in this case. That means that MyHeritage has 4 and Ancestry has 2, and you know what? With a score like that, MyHeritage is going to win overall. I think that they have a little bit better system for sorting and filtering. They have more options available. Now, there are some options on Ancestry that I love, that I would love if MyHeritage would incorporate, but there's also a lot of great features on MyHeritage that Ancestry should incorporate as well. So I hope you enjoyed this. If you'd like to see some of our other matchup videos, check out this video up here. Or if you want to see a playlist about some different features on MyHeritage, check out this playlist down here. And be sure to subscribe to our channel. And make sure you click on that bell if you want to be notified about upcoming episodes.